we want just to go out and do our you know, do our work, like going to supermarket, going to hospital, our rights.
So you support then the women who want to disobey, yes, the driving ban?
Yes, I support them. I will do with them, inshallah, by tomorrow.
So now are
but I'm not going to drive.
Are you saying that, I mean, are you planning to drive tomorrow?
Yes, inshallah.
And so do you know how to drive? I mean, have you had driver training?
A little bit.
A little bit?
A little bit. My brother, he learned me before. But I will try to remember what he learned.
And are you afraid of getting in trouble or some kind of consequences if you...
Always when we're doing something in first time, we get in trouble. Mm. Especially if that's not allowed from our country.
Now,
you know, something happened before in America, like I saw some women do that before in some film, but I'm not remember about what.
Well, I heard a story this morning that said that the first time that women defied the ban on female drivers was back in 1990. So I don't know how many times it's happened since.
You believe that my grandma and the old lady in Saudi Arabia, before they drive the car before.
And
when I youngest, I saw my grandma, she drive the car and she go... like them and no problem about it, but I don't know what happened after that.
And so you're planning tomorrow to drive in this protest. Do you have any plans of where you're going to drive to?
No, I want to take my car and have a round.
And so you're excited to get out there tomorrow and drive around. Just
do. Yes, excited, and I want to do it that.
Do you think that the ban, and now in this story I heard this morning, this is not actually a law, is that correct, that there's no law against female drivers, but there's the religious authorities have basically have banned it?
The Saudi Arabia, it's a new country, not like America. It have history like America or like UK. They didn't have a law about this. They didn't have a law about it's allowed or not allowed. About the culture, not about the law. It's about the culture.
Do you think that things will change in the next few years? I mean, do you think that this ban will be eased, perhaps?
It's a change. It's a change, yes. I would think. I will believe it's a change.
Here in Egypt, there is a difference in opinions between acceptance and refusing to what's happening, and some people disagree with the army, and I'm one of these people who disagree.
You're saying you're one of the people who disagree with the army having removed the president. Is that what you're saying? You yourself are one of the people who disagree or not?
I'm one of these people who disagree with the army. I want Dr. Morsi to be the president of our country because he has the right to, and we give him our voice, and we wanted him. And
what do you think will happen next? I mean, you and, you know, being there, reading the news, seeing the events going on, what do you think is going to be happening with Egypt?
I think that Dr. Morsi will come back, travel.
How so? How do you mean back to the presidency, you think?
Yes, maybe with some conditions or some changes, but I think everything will be okay and go in the right way. or the logical way.
Your Prime Minister, Nawaz Sharif, was here. Have you been watching the news about that? Do you have any...
Yeah, I followed that news because of my interest in politics. So, yeah, there is a lot of reaction and action in the thoughts and about this, you know, this this meeting with U.S. President,
mm-hmm.
This meeting with U.S. President of Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif. Yes, there were lots of hopes with that meeting. For instance, about drone strikes.
Mm-hmm.
This is a serious issue in Pakistan, drone strikes. And people are very hostile to it because they think that a country should not have the right to intervene a country's border. And if there is any problem, like if America has the intel of terrorism, or the intel of terrorists, that there are some terrorists are residing in, at this place, so this information should be given to Pak Army and the ISI. And after that, the action against terrorism, terrorism should be taken by the local forces, not by any foreign force. Foreign force.
Well, now, what about what critics have said over the years that the Pakistanis, that the local forces, as you just referred to them, have not been doing enough to go after, you know, the terrorists, and so then. So what about those criticisms?
Well, if looking at the fact that most of the sacrifice is paid by Pakistan forces, mm-hmm. so this saying blatantly that Pakistan or Pakistani forces are not going after terrorists and not making the world a safe place to live, so I don't think this is a good or a serious comment on Pakistani forces' sacrifices. And there are lots of martyrs and lots of survivors of this war, and they all belong to Pakistan forces, and they take pride of this, that we have fought against terrorism and we have tried to make our country a safer place.
I don't know if you're following Pakistan media or not, but there's a lot of negative comments and a lot of, you know, issues they were highlighting. For example, they don't see really, you know, there hasn't been much progress over drone strikes by United States, you know, in certain area in Pakistan. And also, you know, there are a lot of different opinions. There were some people of opinion that, you know, these meetings actually produce nothing. They're a waste of time and resources, and most things are decided beforehand. And there are other people who were actually pretty optimistic, and they were thinking that actually something is going to come out. And Prime Minister went there, spent a lot of time there. So as soon as he comes back, probably he's going to take the whole nation into confidence and let them know what actually he has achieved in meeting with Obama.
So are you one of the optimists, or are you one of the people thinking nothing's going to come out of it?
I'm somewhere in between. I know there's a lot of diplomacy there. I know these guys are really not telling the exact story to Pakistani people. But at the same time, I know that the meeting was just not for the sake of meeting. There was something they wanted to achieve. But unfortunately, we don't know exactly what they discussed. I mean, besides what they shared with the media, we don't know exactly what went on, they were trying to achieve. If you read Indian media, apparently Obama raised all the issues the Indian government has been asking them to help them with Pakistan. For example, they think that Pakistan has been involved in cross-border terrorism. So according to them, it was their victory. According to Pakistani media, it was not neither their victory nor our victory. It was like just a envelope or whatever type of diplomatic meeting.
Yeah, in Afghanistan is all the news about the elections and about the candidates that they want to be a president of Afghanistan. There is a problem on some of them. So the government of Afghanistan don't let them to, you know, be candidate of the presidents because of some problem that they have, like some of them have a bilingual, you know, citizenship, African and American. So the government say that you should be just Afghan or American. You cannot be both of them at the same time.
Well, what do you think about what's going on with the elections? Do you see any candidates that you that have impressed you so far to replace President Karzai?
I think that there is no best man between them, but the choice is, in effect, the choice is between bad and better.
No, bad and worse.
Bad and worse. Yeah, sorry. Bad and worse. Mm-hmm. Choice is bad between bad and worse. We should use. We should choose the bad, not worse. because they have a bad background, all of them. They kill many people about 20 or 50 years ago, and all the people of Afghanistan knows. But some of them have a good policy, you know, they're educated person. I think I chose one of that educated and have a good policy.